I'm Chris O'Reilly, one of the directors of Gothenburg Fringe. We first came into touch with United Cowboys last year as part of the Perform Europe open call, which was all about sustainable touring. And a lot of organizations got in touch with us, a lot of companies got in touch with us. But when we saw them and their performance, we knew immediately that we wanted to work with them. In the end, from about 500 different organizations that got through to a second stage of that, only 19 projects were chosen. So we were really lucky to get the funding to do this. So when it comes to United Cowboys themselves and our contact with them, what really stood out for us was the fact that they wanted to create this biotope in a space that was almost empty. They wanted to take over and challenge the space with historical context usually. And so Kronhuset became a natural choice for us. I think when we saw it the first time, that immediately popped out to us. And we said, okay, Cowboys at Kronhuset, that's an easy fit there. And I think that's proven to be the case as well. They came into an empty Rikssalen at the beginning of the week, and they've transformed it into something really incredible. And I think that's the major takeaway from this, showing that these spaces can be turned into something that is very almost postmodern, and shows that you can have a sustainable approach to using venues like this. You don't need to create new things all the time. You can make use of what's already there. And this 17th century house is a great example of that. So hopefully people get to experience that as well during the 4-hour performance, and we'll get to appreciate that as well, because a lot of people who've been in this house before will not recognize it when they come in this evening.
So a day in the biotope looks quite different each day. We have a routine though. We warm up with a fantastic dancer and dance teacher, Gaetano Badalamenti. He has been working with us, warming up quite softly, working with a technique called gyrotonics. The audience visiting the biotope, I think, will discover a couple of things within themselves through watching, through listening, through maybe hearing, sensing, even tasting. So the biotope is an experience for most of the senses, I think. They will see a group, but also individuals, exploring and maybe pushing a couple of limits, but in a consensual way.
So for me, the peace, it means an ongoing decision taking, a materialization of intuition, and an expression of the being.
I just don't know what to do with myself. Don't know just what to do with myself. I'm so used to doing everything with you, planning everything for two. And now that we're through, I just don't know what to do with my time. I'm so lonesome for you, it's a crime.
I think the show is really interesting. It's enticing, and it's a dreamlike state. And I like the contrast between the silver screen, where there is notions of fascism, nationalistic tendencies and the attempts to make sense of the world that happens on the biotope.
I felt that I wanted to kind of read the backstory of every character and to know more and maybe to understand more.
Yeah, well, I think I saw kind of like a live painting, kind of with no connection to some of the things that was going on. Would be nice to see a clear connection to it all.
Watching this really makes me want to be a part of it. I feel like it's another thing to watch it. It's also interesting to watch it, but I really want to jump in and to be a part of it more than to watch it, really. But it's super cool to also get to watch it.